Hello everyone and welcome to PMT College, powered by professional music technology. My name is Leigh Fuge and I'm here today with musicteacher.com, and in this video we're going to talk about the basics of hybrid picking. So as you may have noticed in the little intro there, hybrid picking is when you use your plectrum and a finger from your picking hand to pick different strings at the same time or at different times. This is quite an advanced technique, but in this video we're going to break down the basics of the technique to get you guys started. All the tones you're hearing in this video are coming from my PRS S2 Studio, which is plugged into the Blackstar Silverline Deluxe. My voice is being recorded today with the Rode Go clip-on microphone. So the technique of hybrid picking is quite an advanced technique, and a lot of guitar players do struggle to integrate this into their playing at first. So in this video, I'm going to give you a couple of techniques that you can use to integrate hybrid picking as both a rhythm guitar and a lead guitar technique into your guitar playing. So let's start by breaking down the technique of hybrid picking at its most basic level. I'm going to use my pick and the middle finger on my picking hand for this. So I'm just going to play a power chord style shape. It doesn't really matter where I do this, but I'm going to do the 5th fret on the D string and the 7 on the G. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to hybrid pick this chord. So typically we may alternate pick this chord like this. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick the D string as a downstroke with my pick, and the G is an up with my middle finger. Many players like to use hybrid picking as a technique because they feel it makes their playing a little bit more efficient. So instead of making big movements for the pick, I'm counteracting that by using a finger to introduce another string. So my hand is actually moving less, even though I'm doing more with the hand, it's not making as much travel between different strings or different notes. Not only can it be a more efficient way of playing, but it can also allow us to connect notes that aren't on strings that are next to each other. So in the intro, for instance, I was playing notes on the G and E string without moving my pick between those two strings. So when you're working on the technique, just move that chord shape around to some different places and try it on different strings as well. Just remember that the finger that you're integrating is replacing one of the directional movements with your pick. Most players prefer to do this on the up, so they're using the plectrum on the down and the hybrid movement on the up. Now you can hybrid pick with fingers beyond your middle finger, but for the purpose of this lesson, we'll just stick to the pick and the middle finger. So here are a couple of exercises you can use. We'll start off with two rhythm guitar exercises, and then we'll look at some lead guitar exercises as well. So the first rhythm guitar exercise I'm going to show you is this simple chord progression. So in this exercise, I'm using a few simple 3-string chords. I'm using an A power chord here, so that's the open A string and the 2nd on the D and G. Now the picking is what's important here. You'll notice that I'm hybrid picking this. So I'm picking down, down on the A and D, and then I'm hybrid picking the up on the G with the middle finger. So that's actually my picking pattern for the whole thing. It's A, D, G. So the G is the up with the middle. Think of this like a rolling pattern, because I'm using triplets here, 1 and a 2 and a. So I'm doing the A on the 1. On the 2nd beat, I'm playing the 2nd fret of the A string and the open D and G. The 3rd beat, I'm doing this sort of C major triad here. So this is the 3rd fret of the A string, the 2nd fret of the D, and the open G. And then on the 4th beat, I'm doing this variation of a D, which is the 5th fret on the A string, the 4th fret on the D string, and the open G. So it's... And the second half of the exercise was just the same thing backwards. So it's 4 beats of triplets going up and 4 beats of triplets coming back. So that exercise is great for getting your fingers into some rolling hybrid picking patterns. The second exercise we're doing is going to be using more conventional chords, and I'm actually going to be playing 2 notes at the same time. The exercise goes like this. So for this, I was using a few simple chord shapes. I'm using an A minor chord, a C chord, a D minor chord, and then on the way back down, I'm playing another C, and then I'm dropping the root of that C to this B note, before landing back on the A minor chord. So much like the first exercise, the picking pattern for each chord here is exactly the same, with the exception of the final bar. So I'm starting off with the A minor chord. I'm picking the A string, which is the root of the chord, and the B string at the same time. So I'm picking the A with a pick and the B with the middle finger. Then I'm playing the D and G strings as picked notes, and then a hybrid note on the B again with the middle finger. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Doing the same thing on the C chord. Doing the same thing on the D minor chord, but now I'm shifting everything down a string. So my root is now on the D string, and the note that I'm hybrid picking is on the E. Then I'm coming back to the C, and I'm playing the A and B strings together, and then I'm picking just the D. Then I'm dropping that root note to the B note and doing the same thing. So it's A minor, C, D minor, then we've got that little walk down at the end. So this exercise makes use of string crossing, so it's quite tricky to start with, but start off slow, focus on getting every note clean and rhythmically in time. So now we're going to look at some exercises that bring hybrid picking from rhythm guitar into lead guitar. So there's a couple of simple exercises to get you started. The first one is going to be a little bit like the item that I played in the intro of this video. This is a concept known as sliding sixths. Now you don't need to worry too much about the theory of this, but this is quite a cool little thing to put into a blues solo. So what I'm doing here is I'm playing notes on the G and E string at the same time. So I'm starting off by picking the G, and I'm always using my middle finger to play the E string. So the first thing I'm doing is sliding from the 5 to the 6 on the G, and then I'm picking the E. Then I'm sliding from the 6 to the 7, and then I'm picking the 7 on the E, so I'm always playing two notes at the same time. The one on the G is always slid. Then I'm sliding from the 7 to the 9 on the G, and playing the 9 on the E. Then the 9 to the 11, and playing the 10 on the E. Then I'm doing this backwards, so I'm going back to the 9, I'm sliding up to the 11. Playing that 10 again, slide down to the 9, play the 9 on the E, then down to the 7, then down to the 6. So the lick as it was there was in the key of A major or F sharp minor, but you can move that around to suit whatever key you're playing in. If you're playing over an A major blues or an F sharp minor blues, that lick will work great. The next lick is a simple triplet hybrid picking lick that shows how you can bring hybrid picking into some fast bluesy licks. So this lick is also in A minor. It's a simple triplet phrase here on the A minor pentatonic on the 5 and 7 of the D, and the 5 of the G. So what I'm doing here is I'm hammering on from the 5 to the 7 on the D, I'm picking that note with my plectrum, and then I'm using a hybrid note on the 5th of the G. Triplets, 1 and a. I'm rolling that for a full bar, so 1 and a, 2 and a, 3 and a, 4 and a. Then on the next first beat, I'm sliding from the 7 to the 9 on the G, I'm picking that note, and then I'm using my middle finger to play the 8 on the B. So I'm going 4 beats on the first triplet, then the second triplet, and all together. You can come up with interesting triplet style licks using hybrid picking. It's a great way to get some speed into your playing. When you get comfortable with the technique, you can really roll those triplets quickly. It's a great way to introduce some speed into your guitar playing without needing to worry too much about your overall pick accuracy. You can really get a lot of notes in there just by adding that middle finger. The final exercise I'm going to show you can be used as a lead guitar lick or a run, but I prefer this just as an overall coordination exercise, and it's using the entirety of the A minor pentatonic scale. So here's how it sounds. So this is just a run of descending triplets from the highest note of the scale all the way down to the lowest. What I'm doing is I'm starting off with a pull off from the 8 to the 5 on the E string, which I'm using my middle finger for. And then I'm down picking the 8th fret on the B string. So that's my first triplet. My second triplet is just the 5 on the E string with a pull off from the 8 to the 5 on the B string. Now the direction that I'm picking this is I'm up picking the E note, and then I'm actually up picking the note on the B string. You can pick this as a down if you're more comfortable doing that. So I'm actually going down on the first pick stroke, up on the second with those hybrid notes before it. So the hybrid picking note actually leads this lick. It actually starts off each of the triplets. That in itself could be used as an exercise just to get that rolling thing going again. So once I get to the end of that first pair of triplets, I'm then just moving up a string and starting it from the B string. But what my picking hand is doing is exactly the same. So I'm leading with a pull off with the middle finger, followed by a single pick stroke, then a single note with the middle finger, followed by a pull off with the pick. And I'm doing the same down on the first, up on the second. Then you just carry on up the scale. That's a great exercise for working on your coordination across multiple strings with hybrid picking. So there you go, there are 5 exercises and a little overview of the basics of hybrid picking on the guitar. Let me know down below in the comments how you got on with that technique, and if there are any other techniques you'd like to see us break down in these videos, please throw those below as well. Don't forget to check out PMTVUK on YouTube for more free video lessons just like this. And if you're looking for a guitar teacher in your local area, please check out musicteacher.com. Check out the database of great music teachers all around the country waiting to help you guys out. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.